Welcome to the Salt Podcast.
Welcome back for the last week of the term, term one. Yeah, my name's Josh.
I'm Sarah.
Welcome back for some midweek encouragement and fun while we do that as well. Now, Sarah, what is the game we're going to play today?
We're going to play higher or lower today.
We sure are. Now, yes. The way this game works is many things are searched on Google, and this app goes, well, is one thing searched higher or lower than the other? So okay. The first one we have is NWA. On 360,000 monthly searches,
okay.
Or the Pittsburgh Steelers, which are an NFL team.
I think the Pittsburgh Steelers are searched more, higher.
Yeah, we just had the Super Bowl, so higher. 1,500,000, smashed it.
Wow.
All right, next one.
Okay.
Pittsburgh Steelers or anxiety?
Oh, anxiety, for sure.
For sure.
Higher.
Higher. You are wrong.
Oh, okay. There was so much confidence going into that.
I mean, I'll read out what it says. You
okay.
scored one. That's a terrible score. The average is 3.2.
Wow.
Put some effort into it. Ugh. Smiley face.
Smiley face. I think that really saved me. All right. Yeah. Ready?
Okay.
Your turn. Formula One versus body odor.
How many for Formula One?
2 million, well, 2.7 million.
Far out. Okay. I reckon body odor is lower then.
Okay.
Yeah.
I agree.
Cool.
Yes. Well done. All right. 1 point to you. Next. Body odor has 14,000 searches a month versus mm-hmm. The Simpsons.
Oh, Simpsons would be way higher. Yeah.
Interesting.
You reckon body odor is... Yeah. Wasn't that
part of me wanted body odor to be higher, but okay. The Simpsons versus snowboard.
Snowboard. Snowboard is higher.
You think snowboard's higher? You are correct. Okay, snowboard versus Wimbledon.
Wimbledon higher.
Higher. Yeah.
Lovely.
Great. Okay. Margaret Thatcher? That's a tricky one.
Lower. Oh, how many
wow,
was that?
17. Let me read you
wow.
what they say.
Uh-huh.
That's an awesome score. You're in the top 10% of players. Share
oh, wow.
it on social and tag us in the post, Josh. Tag them.
That's lovely. Thanks. I'm definitely going to skip most of that in this edit. Now, what is the challenge for this Friday, Sarah? What is a Friday challenge?
Yeah. So the challenge on Friday is going to be the first person to show Josh your favorite childhood toy. So it could be a stuffed bunny, a truck. Maybe you had like this really special thing your grandma knit for you. Got to show it to Josh.
Mm-hmm.
The first person to do something will win a prize, and it has to be your favorite toy,
yeah.
not your second favorite.
Yeah. Speaking of favorites, it will be a favorites box. One of those
right.
big favorites boxes, not the little ones.
No,
they were on special. They cost a lot, but they're really good. So get excited for that. Now, we come
Excellent.
Here for the devotions to get stuck into God's word, Sarah.
Yep.
What is the passage that we'll be looking at this Friday?
Yeah, so we're looking at Colossians chapter 1, verse 13 and 14. So
Lovely.
I'm just going to read that for us now.
Thank you.
For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins.
Lovely. Now, there's a lot in that passage, a lot to unpack when we come back on Friday night to look at it. Something I thought was interesting was in verse 13, it says, "For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves." Now, brought us is actually an interesting translation that he used that because in the original language, it's actually a word that's more like conveyed. He conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son he loves. Now, when I read that, that doesn't make sense. The idea back in the day was that if you had two kings who were in charge of two kingdoms and one king and his kingdom beat another, then those people in the kingdom that lost were brought into, or rather conveyed into the kingdom of the king that won. And so that's the idea that we see here. Jesus is the king of God's kingdom, Satan being the king of the other, and Jesus defeats death, defeats Satan, and conveys us into the kingdom of the Son, who is Jesus, who God loves, which is just an awesome, awesome image. And we
yeah.
see in verse 14 how he does that, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Forgiveness through the redemption, which is this price that is paid by Jesus for us. And what an awesome joy that is that we can look forward to being in God's kingdom forever.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Now, what was the song that we listened to yesterday, Sarah?
Yeah, so the song was My Soul Will Wait, and it was Psalm 62. And yeah, the verses that really resonated with me, they went like this. Through your sacrifice so great, I have peace that's undeserved. For the battle has been won. I fear no shame or loss. Now the sting of death is gone. You're my rock and my salvation. And the sting of death is gone because Jesus has died in our place so that we don't have to face God's punishment forever. And that really resonated with me because it really shapes the way we're meant to live now that Jesus has, yeah, paid that price for us. And we don't have to fear death. Death is something that all human beings share in common, is that we will all die one day. But because Jesus has died for us and, you know, like in verse 14, we have redemption and our sins have been forgiven. And so the way we live our lives is that we don't need to, fear dying or live our lives accumulating all this wealth before we die so that we have all these things, but it's eternity that we look forward to.
For sure. Yeah. What an awesome, comforting truth to know.
Yeah.
For sure. Mm. Now, thank you for coming today to the Salt Podcast. Last one of the term. Get keen for Friday night when you can show me your favorite toy and you get a favorites box for that.
Yep.
First one to do that wins it. See you at Awesome, right?
Yeah, that's see you at Awesome.
We'll see you. Yeah.
So exciting. Bye.